Hello and welcome to the next part of our tutorial series. In the last part we have bring in our project the car driving. And in this part we will bring a health bar from our player. We will using for this the inventory pro. We have looking at the last part. Have we bring it in and we have bring car driving. And yet we will fix in here the white box, yeah, and how we can do it. So let's start. We open here our player, our import stuff, and here we have the UI from the last parts of our tutorial series. And here we're looking for the info border. That is the info border here. And here we have missing font. We're looking for it. We take whatever you want. I use this font and then we have looking here, press E. So at the next, we're looking for add component. We're looking for FSM, a Playmaker FSM, looking here and notice UI with that name for it. So the name is, you can take your name whatever you want. So let's going in the edit mode. Here are we in the Playmaker and we go into events. We make start fast as one. Then we make on and we make it off. So at first start fast here. Set a start, delete this, and the second is on, and the next one will be off. So, okay. And we're looking here for a bool test. And we create a new global variable. And you or notice UI with that name for it. We create it here. And when it's true, going to on and then going to off every frame. And we're going to on and bool, we're looking for a bool non-true. Make it here the one, looking for our global notice UI. And that is going to off every frame. So, and here we're looking for a bool all true, make it one, and here global notice UI and then going to on every frame. So what is it? Really easy. We have create here a bool at the first start. He looking, it's a bool, it's on or it's off every frame. When it's on, he going in this. When it fails or when it's true, he going to on, and when it failed the bool variable, he going to off. And when it's here in off and the bool variable notice UI is true, he going here, and when it's not more true, he going back to off. That's it. And what we are looking for it here, the function, what we are doing with this is show, or here UI show and hide UI window. And for this, we putting that here, the info border, and here we will show it, and we move it up, and copy this, and we pass this here, and here it's not more, and we copy it and pass it here, so not more on. So, and the next is we looking for our Sandero or our car, what we have creating. We have here the enter car, that is the white box. So we're going to this, and we're going here in it, and we set a bool value. So we copy, we remove it, we copy this and we put it here, and we set the global notice UI. So here we remove it, and we have here when it going out in it in a we have here going out from the trigger event, the exit, and he send event start phase. So for that, we make it here a finished hold left control and click on it and then come finished. And we make here add state, we'll put it here. And now it's not more start phase is finished. So that is on and here off. And we're looking for next frame event. That bring us to our start phase here, yeah. So when we have here this bool, the set bool value in this, so when will it set it off? That is not what we want. So that is why we create here finished, that make it off the bool variable and or set is as false, not more as true. So the next is when he press it E, so we copy this and we pass it here before and we make here not more, make it as false. So when you are getting out of the car, I think that's all okay. So we can make a test. And for this, we have here the mesh renderer, and for the moment we not remove it. We need it later when we make it here entry on the other side and so on. But we can disable it. So and you see, when I make it on, we see the white box, and when I make it off, the white box is not more in that. So let's make a test for it. So here we are, and when I go into my car, I make get here press E, yeah. And when I set going out from the car or go back from the car, that will not more activated, yeah. So when I press E, so I'm in a car and I see not more the notice button, and when I press E going out, stand here, and then comes it, yeah. So that's it. And the same we're doing here on our zombie female on Z. And we're going here in a trigger, it's the same. And we looking here for set bool value. And that is our notice UI. And make it this here a little deeper. And we create a finished on it and we bring it here. And then we looking here for finished. And we copy this, going here, past it here, and we set the next frame. Next frame event will ask bring to the start phase. Okay. And we copy this. And we going here, past action before, and we take it off. And we name taken here the mesh renderer disabled. So and let us see, we make a test for it. So here's our zombie woman, and you see when I going in, press E come, and then I'm going back out. A lot more, and when I press E, we see here, press E, the info line, it's not more. So when I go in here, I press it. So that is the first what we are have doing here. So let me disable our zombie woman. And the next is we will creating here. So let me take it out here. And next is we will creating a health bar. So at the moment, we're looking here for the player info, and we have here a missing sprite and so on, and we have here the health, and we need a state. So for create this, we're going to tools, inventory pro, and open the main editor. This is this. Yeah, so we have here for the items, we have here for the money, for the equipment, for the crafting. We can here create crafting blueprints, the language editor. So but we need here on the item editor, we're looking for the item stat, and we create a stat, and the category at the moment is the full, yeah. And we looking here in a category, we create a category, and we call it player. Yeah. So that is a player category. We need no sprite and a cooldown at the moment. We need it not. So back to the stat. And the category, we call it player. And the name is health. Yeah. And we're looking here. We have start row slider, start row, and so on. And when I go in here, I have here player health created. And I put it here in it. And I'm looking here for start row slider as it. So, and the base start of is here we can setting up some functions for experience, for stats and so on. And here we can set auto progress level or when he get a level up, get more life. But for our here, we have a value from 100 and the base start is 100. Yeah. So that is what we are creating. So that can be closed. So use a current player, that's okay. So, and now we're going here in a slider and let's take a look on it. We have here a mask, the mask can disable for the moment. Frame can disable for the moment. So we're going here, that is the health, the slider here on it, and background and the fill area. Then we have here a text, and this can be setting off. And we don't need it here. So, and let me take a look for a sprite heavy something. We can use this for testing. So let's see. So here is our health bar. So let me press E. We see nothing. So we have here, and we see here text 9000 from 10,000, and take a look here. So here it's all okay. That name. So and here we're giving this font. We have here that stand. Not good to see at the moment. And this can setting off. So we found the player, that's okay. So let me take in the looking in the main editor. That's okay. That is okay. Okay. So that is currency, that's not a problem at the moment. The problem at the moment is we must set here the slider in it, I think. We must setting up this here. Yeah, this is the fill area. So for this fill here, the slider here in it. So revision clip, not what we need. That name, this is text, and yeah, okay, let's make a test. Yeah, and you see it's will fill it. At the moment we have not got boar here, but it you have see is will be filled, yeah. And fill it from left to right. We have here the background. We have at the moment no source image. And yeah, that's it. And when I open this and I will set it up here to 50. Yeah, that is a base start. Our player start now with 50. So let's take a look. And you see it fills here only the half, yes. So, and let's take a look what it's doing here, what's going up here. So that is the health stat, yeah, that is here in it. And we have stat UI that came, this script came from Inventory Pro. The stat here is the player health. The player is the category and health is the stat what we are creating here in our category and in our stat here. Here's the health, the category is player, and yes, it's here. Okay. So as next, use current player. So that is what player he will using. We can setting up here other player, but that is for our character, for our player here. So we said use current player, yes. That is how fast that will fill. Here we must not changing. So here we can setting up the stat name. Here we giving this in it. And the text field is we have setting up, we can duplicate this when we want. Or we bring other text when we had needed to it here. Yeah. The text format of is round to decimal. The health here, what we have is Integer. And Integer have no 1.2 or something. It's only the full number. And then we need here the slider. You have see here for filling the health bar, the slider. And here image at the moment we're using this image here, the loading bar. Later I will looking for other frames here. And the idea is, let me start it. So see it better. So we see here health, yeah. And later I think we make in the under left corner here our stats. Yeah, our stats for health, for thirsty, for hunger and so on. This come here in the left corner. I think that's better. But yeah, that is we have a health bar, yes. In the next tutorial, we were looking how we can get damage with our guy here. And we will get damage and dying, that is. And we will in the next part of it looking how we can equip a gas mask. So my idea is we create a little area. When the player is in this area, he get damage. The damage will reduce here our health bar. And when it's zero, our player die. And then we will bring a gas mask in it. And when the player then with the gas mask on going in this area, he will get no damage. Yeah, this is the idea for the next part of the tutorial. But in this part, we have bringing up our first category and we have setting up a health bar. So, and you see this error, I think you when you're using this asset, what I use, you can remove it and then you have not more this problem. Some words to the end. At the last week, some people's questioned me, can we use free asset or from Xiaomi the asset and so on. The problem is, I cannot support it you when you have questions, when you use your own asset and not understanding what we are doing here. Yeah, I think when you have a good experience in Unity and in Playmaker and you understand that here, you have no problems to bring your own stuff in it. But when you're an absolutely beginner, that will be very hard. And the next problem is when we are going to the weapons for the aiming, I'm using Final IK. And that can you, buying in an asset store. That is a problem from Unity when I look into Unreal. Unreal Engine 4 bring all the third party stuff in it, and then Unity you must creating that or you buying that. So you can creating a final IK system in Unity or IK system for aiming in Unity. And I have looking a long time to find a good system for it. And for me, the best solution was Final IK. But in Unreal Engine 4, I have an aiming system in it. The same is with the camera. When we are looking the camera in for when you are starting a project on the Unreal Engine 4, and you say this project will a third person, you can select it, and you have a camera with a collision. Yeah, so the camera detected the walls and so on. And here in Unity, we have the main camera, and we have only this in it here. Yeah, we have the component camera, and that's it. Yeah, and that is why when you are saying you will not spending money in game developing, you have two options. You can use it in Unity, and when you are an absolutely beginner, I can tell you your controller will looking ugly. You can searching on YouTube GTA 5 controller download for free, and you can download this controller, but it looks totally ugly. Yes. And on Unreal Engine 4 you get every month free stuff. Yeah. And I have looking this month you getting a template with to creating turn-based fighting game, so like Final Fantasy 7, the old game, not the remake, and you can create it with that, yeah, and that's very cool. And this you have all in this template that is free, that cost $80 in the store, but this month it's free, yeah, and you can get it, and you can bring off characters from Paragon that is for free, and you create your little Final Fantasy game. Yeah, that's really great. And you must not paying for this. You have an inventory in it, you have a main menu in it, you have a save and load, you have all this in it. Yeah, and every month you get a free asset from it. Yeah, that is a free of the month. Call it an Unreal place, and that's very cool. And that is what you are, when you are say you will no pay for some assets, that's okay, but I think then it's a better turn for you to going to the Unreal Engine, yeah. And when I look, when I see, looking for my hourly wages, what I become on my main job, so I looking, The camera controller from OT costs at the moment $25. That is in my main job to get $25. So I work 1 hour and a half hour, then I have that. So, and in 90 minutes, I cannot create this game controller for a third person camera. Yeah, that is what I can tell. Or the other is in 4 hours, I cannot create an animation pack like that from Crewbot. So in my free time, and the big beast in the developing is the money, but not only the money. That is a free time. How many free time have you to creating a game? So for me, sometimes I have no time. Sometimes I have 2 hours on a day time to setting up my game, bringing new stuff in it, in a. And yes, that's it. That is why I think, okay, I using this asset that saved me time. Yeah. So, but when you're saying, yes, I will create a good looking game, I will create multiplayer game and so on, and then it's the best way going to Unreal Engine 4. That's it. Yeah. Okay, that's from my side. I hope that help you here to creating your health, health bar. Later we will polish it. We will it in the left. We bring it to the left corner so that looks more better. We bring some icons for it. We polish it. But for the moment, it's okay to see we have health. Yes. Okay, that's it. Thank you for watching. I'm out. Bye bye.